Welcome back to CryptoTorrel. On today's video, I would like to discuss XRP, how it's currently performing, and what we could expect during the upcoming hours and days. But before doing so, I would highly appreciate if you could give me a thumbs up down below. And as well, if you are not subscribed yet, don't forget to smash up that subscribe button. So this being said, I would like to start right away on XRP. What we can clearly see on the 4-hourly time frame, if we zoom out a little bit, is that we are still underneath this descending resistance. And I think it is actually very important to monitor this descending resistance with multiple touch points underneath for sure, especially if we are going to see an increase in price action. Because if we do see an increase, I personally think that this will be still a major level of resistance, and we could perhaps expect a rejection once we will be reaching this range. So therefore, I clearly would like to talk about this descending resistance due to the fact that we could expect a rejection taking place once we see an increase in price action right now. So for sure, this is a level above us that we have to take into consideration as a potential level of resistance where we could get rejected. What else are we seeing on the chart? Well, for sure, I think this is quite good to know that for the last time we were actually at these ranges where we are currently trading at on XRP, it was the 8th of August of 2021. As well, we have seen this on the 31st of July. We were at these ranges and we were experiencing resistance underneath where we are currently finding support on top. So you could clearly see that we were experiencing resistance underneath where we are currently finding support on top, and we did experience as well support before. So this is for sure something I think is quite important to know so far. So we are actually right now at a stronghold of previous resistance, finding support on top of it. So that is for sure something I think is quite noticeable. What else are we going to look at during this video? Well, for sure, I would like to get started by looking at the MACD. On the MACD, what you can clearly see is that we are heading towards a crossover. I personally think it will be inevitable that we are going to see right now a crossover taking place. Therefore, we will also see an increase of price action getting started. But as I said previously, I'm actually concerned about this descending resistance as a level where we could get rejected afterwards. That is one of the possibilities. For sure, if we do see a breakout occur above it and we do hold strong on top of it, further continuation is absolutely likely. But right now, what I must admit is that we have to be very careful and see if this further increase in price action will actually be taking place. Therefore, I would like to take a look at the 1-hourly time frame where we are clearly as well, experiencing momentum towards the downside, and we are heading towards a crossover of upward momentum. This is actually looking very bright to me. So I do actually expect that we are going to see a potential increase in price action, but we could get rejected at the 0.5 Fibonacci or underneath the descending resistance at approximately 96 dollar cents. Lastly, on the daily time frame, I would like to discuss the MACD as well. What you can clearly see is that we already experienced major momentum towards the downside already several weeks. We started on the 14th of November. We have ever since that point in time seen just a further decline of price action. What I think is actually good to know is that if we do right now see an increase in price action, we will for sure see as well a decline in momentum strength towards the downside. And therefore, I personally think that it is likely that we are going to see a crossover taking place in the near future. And this will be of absolute importance to see a further continuation on the chart. Lastly, I would like to say as well, on the daily time frame, I would like to discuss the EMA ribbon. Clearly, it's serving as a level of resistance, and you can see that on the 0.5 range at 96 dollar cents, it's not just this descending resistance, it's as well this horizontal level of support where we did find support on top and resistance underneath previously, but as well the EMA ribbon. So the $96 range will be for sure a range where we have to be very doubtful about if we are going to be able to break out above it. And if we would like to see that breakout occur above the 0.5 Fibonacci at 96 dollar cents, we will for sure like to see eventually the crossover taking place on the daily MACD to see even more continuation of momentum towards the upside. Lastly, I would like to discuss the RSI as well. On the RSI, what you can clearly see on the daily time frame is that we are actually quite far below. We are breaking down below the dotted line already for several hours. And what I think is absolutely important is that actually we could expect right now a reversal on the RSI, strength increasing, and as well an increase in price action. As well, the MACD is showing this too. So therefore, I am actually quite confident about the development so far. And lastly, on the 4-hourly time frame, you can clearly see that we are as well heading towards a breakdown once more below the dotted line, and therefore I think it is actually quite likely that we are going to see an increase afterwards, and that is exactly what we were seeing as well on the 4-hourly MACD. So right now I am actually quite positive about that we are going to see a stronghold getting created on top of the $0.67, and that we will experience an increase of momentum afterwards. So that is something I think is quite important to know right now. And lastly, I would like to discuss the EMA ribbon on the 4-hourly time frame. What you can clearly see is that the EMA ribbon is right now actually quite far below. It's way further down than the descending resistance I've talked about previously. This descending resistance is a little bit higher. The EMA ribbon is right now serving as a level of resistance at approximately $0.86, and therefore it will be a difficult level to break out above. And I think this entire range in between this $0.86 and $0.96 will be actually a stronghold of resistance that we have to break out above if we would see a further continuation. But for sure, if we head towards these ranges, a decline in price action is absolutely likely, because we are seeing just major resistance above us, and that is absolutely something you would like to take into consideration. So if you did like the content so far, do not forget to give me a thumbs up down below. It will be highly appreciated, and you will be supporting the channel by doing so. And lastly, I would like to say thank you very much for watching, and have a nice day.